What's going on out there in Radio Land, everybody? This is your host, Tariq King Flex Nasheed. And welcome to another edition of Mack Lessons Radio. How's everybody doing out there? Well, we're back. Another day, another game. Hope everybody's been all right. It's Saturday. And we're broadcasting live from Los Angeles, California. Beautiful day out here in Los Angeles. I hope it's as beautiful in your city as it is here. I'm going to be in Hawaii tomorrow. Hawaii, that's my little home away from home. That's my second home. Like yesterday I said Atlanta was my third favorite city. Hawaii is my second. Honolulu, Hawaii. And LA is my favorite city. But I go to Hawaii to get my creative juices going. I've written most of my books in Hawaii. I do a lot of creative stuff out there. Get in tune with nature. That's important, y'all. People you need to vacation for. Go somewhere where you can get in tune with nature to get your mind right. That's real deep, man, folks. People don't travel. Folks don't get in tune with nature. You just don't get out there and just vibe with earth. You know, I know I'm sounding like a goddamn hippie, but you got to get out there and vibe with the earth, man. Just being around water and trees and just the earth, it really sets your mind right. It really gets your body in tune with where it's supposed to be. Because as humans, man, especially urban dwellers, we live in such unnatural environments with all the pollution, the buildings, the hustle and bustle every day. You know, that sets your mind off a little bit. So it's always good to get your mind back aligned. That's why Hawaii is, that's my spot. That's my alignment spot. As with other spots, it's just good to get out of your neighborhood every now and then, man. You get out of your hood, you go travel, you kick it, you come back home, and you appreciate home more. You appreciate things more once you see, you know, different parts of the world. But anyway, I'm still going on that tour later on this year, man. I'm going to hit up a lot of cities around the country because a lot of people have been asking, when am I coming here? When am I coming to D.C.? When am I coming to Philly? A lot of people have been asking me, when am I coming to Baltimore? I've never really kicked it in Baltimore. I got to get out there with you guys. I was on the radio show out there. I got to get out there to Boston. I've never been to Boston. I've done radio in Boston. I've done a lot of interviews. Like I said, I got to get down to Atlanta. I really miss Atlanta. But anyway, we got a couple of emails. I'm going to chop up game and help this cat out. I got an email from a dude. This brother's name was Devin. And I'm using your names. I'm not going to use your full name, but I'm just using the name that you use when you sent the email. So you put it on the public blog. So don't come back and try to sue me saying I put your business out there. All you people, if you send me an email asking for advice, I might use the name that you use, your screen name. And don't hide. A lot of people, what you do, I ask people to post questions on my blog, and a lot of people will send me a private email, not wanting to put all their business out there, but we need to dialogue more. That's the problem. A lot of men are afraid to chop up game with other cats. Just chop up game, man. Ask questions, sit down, dialogue. Don't worry about being embarrassed, man. Don't worry about asking for help. Don't worry about that ego thing. If you need help, ask for it. I asked for help when I needed help. I ask the right people. Part of learning the game is acknowledging what you don't know. We got a lot of know-it-all cats out there, or guys who pretend to know it all. That's a shield. That's a defense mechanism. You don't know every goddamn thing. I don't know everything. I still learn, man. I still expand my knowledge. I read all the time. I'm always studying. I'm always trying new things. I'm still learning. When I meet older, wiser people, I sit down, zip my lips, and I chop up their game. I listen to them, and I learn from them. A lot of old players, I still listen to them. I still get advice from them. I'm always listening and learning. There's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing to be ashamed of, brothers. Get your learn on. Women aren't ashamed. What's funny, man, when I do lectures, there are damn near more women than men. I remember, like, when I was on my first lecture run, I would do lectures and it would be like 50% men, 50% women. But when I did lectures specifically for women, packed. I did the Women's Expo in North Carolina a couple of years ago, filled to capacity. Women will learn that game. Women will step theirs up. Fellas, you got to step yours up. But I digress. But anyway, I got an email from this brother named Devin. He sent me an email on my MySpace account. And for everybody who don't know, the MySpace account email address or the web address is myspace.com/Reek_Nasheed. You can go to the blog section. Ask me anything you want to ask me. Chop up game. Got a lot of players on there. Creole GQ, I see you, player. Telly, I see you, player. Red Sky, what's up, Red? Thick Red, sexy self. But anyway, got an email from Devin. And Devin is like, yo, Flex. Man, I'm 22, and I just recently obtained my BA. I've acquired a lucrative job, and I've been accepted to grad school. However, I've been in a relationship for like 4 years with a female. And she's about a 7.5 or an 8. And basically, I have no problems out of her. The thing is, I have this conscious need to holler at other females. I'm not trying to have relationships with these other females. Just ask. I'm just wondering, Flex, should I chill before I lose something good, or should I continue doing what I do? Let me know something, player. Signed, Devin Collier. I said your last name, but you put your last name on here, D. And it's a public forum, that's why. So basically, Devin is in a relationship. Devin has his stuff together. Sounds like a brother with a good head on his shoulders. He's with a woman who's pretty average. She's cool. Little average girl next door type, I'm assuming. And he's getting the player itch. Now, Devin, I know you're listening. See, Devin, you're 22 years old, so you shouldn't even be thinking about a serious relationship anyway, because you are going through, or you're about to go through, what we call the player stage. And I touched on this a couple of days ago, and I said I would get to it. I'm going to get to it right now. A couple of days ago on the show, I talked about women going through the hoochie stage. And that hoochie stage, that attention whore stage, is usually between the age of 18 and 22 for women. Because this is when women are on top of their game. Women go through that attention whore stage because between the ages of 18 and 22, women are physically the best shape they're in. The coochie is tight, the ass is tight, the breasts are firm, the face is smooth, the skin has no stretch marks, everything is fly about her, and everybody's trying to holler at them at that point. A lot of cases, these women don't have baggage, they don't have children. in most cases. They don't have any emotional baggage. So these women are very high on the food chain. A lot of dudes are trying to holler at a woman in that attention whore stage, that 18 to 22 year old stage. So these women will milk that for everything it's worth. They're going to get all the attention they can. They're going to milk that. And by the time they get 22, 23, that dwindles down a little bit because they have to start getting serious. See, women are like trying to cram for the test before the age 30. Before the age of 30, women really got to cram for the test and get their shit together. This is psychological stuff that women go through. Because statistics show that when women pass 30, it becomes more difficult for them to get married. And women know this, even on a subconscious level. So, you know, women are forced to get serious at a certain age. Now, with men, every man goes through the player stage. Now, usually, the player stage comes into play when a man is out of college, when he has his first crib. This is around the age of 25, 26. Because you can't be a real player when you don't have nothing. See, when a guy's like 18, 19, 20, you want to be a player, but you're pretty much limited to the hood rats in your vicinity. When you're 18, 19, 20, I mean, you don't have your own crib. You don't have a lucrative job. If you have a car, it's not really a fly ride. So your options are kind of limited. You take what you can get. Like I'm assuming Devin did. Devin's been with this female for 4 years. When he was like 18. See, a lot of dudes get with these women and they're so happy that they're having sex with somebody. They're like, damn, let me wipe this motherfucker up. But what happens is that player stage kicks in. And the player stage, that's the stage where men have to go out there and get as much ass as they can get. When a man goes through that player stage, it's about getting as many notches on his belt as possible. Men have to go through this stage. And like I said, the average stage is between the ages of 26 and about 40. That's the average. Some men go through the stage between 26 and 35. Sometimes it's shorter. Some men go on a 5-year run from 25 to 30. But it's inevitable that men go through this stage. And the reason why men go through that stage in their late 20s is because in your late 20s, you get your crib, you've gotten a great degree, you've gotten a great job. Now you have options. You can date women outside your neighborhood. You've traveled, you've seen women in other cities. So you've expanded your horizons and you want to explore those horizons. And you go through that player stage. Now, when a man does not go through that player stage at a young age, he ends up going through that stage when he gets older. And they like to call that a midlife crisis. It's not a midlife crisis. It's not a crisis at all. He just needs to get that out of his system. Just like a lot of women who had to get married, not had to get married, or who chose to get married. A lot of women who got into serious relationships at a young age during their attention whore stage. When these women get older, that hoochiness still wants to come out. She becomes the old bitch at the club. That's the female you see at the club, 48 years old, wearing some Daisy Dukes, with liver spots all on her ass. You feel what I'm saying? Women have to go through that stage. I'm going to give you an example. I remember Mariah Carey. when Mariah Carey first came out, when she was like, I think she was like 18, 19, something like that, but she was very young. What's the song right here? Y'all remember this song right here? It's Quality Time by High Five. What happened to them niggas? This was the shit. But I digress. Let me turn this up a little bit. Hold on. Sorry, I had to get off point for a minute. This was the shit. Anybody grew up in the 90s, the early 90s? Shit, that's produced by R. Kelly. But anyway, back to what I was saying. Remember Mariah Carey back in the days when she first came out? Mariah Carey was kind of square. She was kind of the goody two-shoes looking female. You know what I'm saying? She was very square, fully clothed, all this stuff. And she got married at a very young age. Mariah Carey got married to Tommy Mottola at a young age. She didn't go through her attention whore stage at that time. Now that Mariah Carey is damn near 40 years old, that bitch can't keep her titties in. Every time you see her, she got on heels and her ass tooted up. She's going through that attention whore stage now. And she's crazy as cat shit, but I love her. I like that. Her craziness is sexy to me. There's something sexy about that crazy bitch. So the point is, whatever you don't complete, you will eventually have to repeat. If you don't complete something, you will repeat it later on in life. So it's good to get certain things out of your system. But like Michael Jackson, they always complained, and he always complained that he really didn't have a childhood, which he probably didn't. The man always called, he's always talking about he didn't complete his childhood. He had to be on the road. He was working all the time. He had to be an adult at a young age. So as he has gotten older, he has regressed into a childhood state again. He's trying to complete that childhood stage, and he's getting his ass in trouble for doing it. But in his mind, he wants to be a kid again because he didn't complete that when he was really a kid. I think it's harmless. I don't think he was fondling baby booty, but that's my opinion. I don't know. The point is, whatever you don't complete, you will repeat. So it's always good to get that out of your system. And as for you, Dev, you know your lady better than we do. You know if your lady's cool. You know if your lady's quality. You know if your lady has her shit together.
Maybe I promise no one else will spend the time.
Now, if you have a decent female, stick with her. Because I know that you are in the player stage. And you don't understand quality yet. Because you haven't tested what's out there. You dig what I'm saying? You have to know what's out there in order to understand good quality. Now, you may have quality, but you don't know it yet because you haven't tested what's out there. You might get from the next female, and the next female might just be the bomb. You know what I'm saying? So, test the waters. But if you have dealt with other women, and your woman is pretty much standing out from that, stick with her. Sometimes it's good to be practical. Sometimes banging other females, it's not worth jeopardizing what you have at home if what you have at home is fly. You dig what I'm saying? Sometimes it's just not worth throwing that away. Sometimes you have to really be disciplined enough to say, okay, look, my woman is cool. I'm not going to fuck that up. A piece of ass ain't worth that. You dig what I'm saying? So you really have to analyze what kind of relationship you have, how cool your woman is, how fly your woman is, because, you know, you want your woman fly. There's nothing wrong with wanting a fly woman. Don't feel guilty because you want to be with a fly bitch. Society tries to make men feel shallow about wanting to be with a dime. We're not shallow. We want a fine bitch, just like a female wants a dude with some paper. Or you want a dude who has his stuff together? You do. If a man doesn't have his shit together, he gets clowned. So why do we have to accept lackluster females if your physical shit ain't together? So don't feel guilty for wanting to be with the best. Now you said, Devin, in your email that your lady was a 7 in your opinion. And I would like to see a picture of your lady, by the way, Dev. If you can, send a email me a picture of that. Email a picture of your lady and we'll be the judge of that, because the standards are kind of different in other cities. And I don't know what city you're in, Dev. But if you're like in Memphis, she's an 8, but on the LA scale, she's a 6. Because we grade on a curve. Because there's basically 5 dime cities in America where there's an abundance of dimes. Now, you have dimes sprinkled out in certain areas around the country, but as far as an abundance of women who are dimes, you have 5 cities. You have Los Angeles, you have Dallas, you have New York, you have Atlanta, and you have Miami. Basically, all the dimes from all around the country, they congregate to these 5 cities. Now, don't get me wrong, there are dimes in other cities, but they're sprinkled in there. You ever meet a woman from like Idaho or Nebraska? You're like, damn, women in Nebraska look like you? She's like real fine. And then you go to Nebraska and everybody looks like a hot mess. She just happened to be the only dime there. That's why she left. So a lot of cities have that kind of phenomenon. You meet women from certain cities and they're real fly, but the reason they left is because shit, it was slim pickings and they wanted to get a baller. So they came to a bigger city. But the point is, man, don't be afraid. Don't be ashamed to want the best type of woman you can get. A lot of dudes, you get in these relationships with females, and Dev, this is what your situation is sounding like. Sounds like you're in a relationship, it's not good enough to stay in, but it's not bad enough to just fuck it off. So you're confused. You want to go out here and explore stuff, but it's that guilt. You don't want to have that guilt, Dev. I know that guilt. You got a decent female, but you still want to bang other broads. But that guilt will tear your ass up. What a lot of dudes do, they start looking for stuff to fault their women for in order to find a reason to justify banging other females. You know, you don't want to do that. If you're going to play the game, you want to play the game fair. And I always say, man, if you want to play the game like that, don't franchise one female. Don't wife up or relationship up one female just to get regular sex. Because that's what it sounds like you're doing, Dev. You just got this female. She was the only female that would have sex with you on a regular basis. Now that your confidence level is kind of up, because the first thing in the email you talked about was all the accomplishments you have going on. Your job is on point. You're about to get a lucrative job. You've been accepted to grad school. Now already you want to get some new poontang. See, a lot of times, guys, you don't have to just pretend to be in a relationship with females just to get regular sex. You don't have to do that, guys. If all you want is ass, just be a bachelor about yours. Get it out your system. And then when you meet that quality woman, she'll stand out and you'll appreciate her more. Trust me, you'll appreciate that woman much more. Because right now, to you, it's all about quantity. It's all about quantity. You want to get as many women as you can get. And that's good to get that out your system. Because eventually you're going to start looking at quality. You're going to get tired of banging all them hood rats and all them chicken heads. One day you're going to wake up and say, you know what? One dime is better than 30 of these raggedy hood rats. It's going to happen, trust me. But really look at your lady and really be honest with yourself. Like, if is your lady cool? Is she worth being in a committed relationship with? Is she worth kicking it with? Is she worth hanging around? And I don't know your situation, man. I don't know if this is a situation where she's paying all the bills right now. I don't know, bro. So I don't want to say kick her to the curb and then your ass is a homeless player. That's why I said it's good to be practical. It's good to stick around if what you're getting at home is better than what you're going to get out there in the streets, man. Sometimes what you're getting out there in the streets is just not worth it. You know, what you going to do? Bust you a little quick nut, then what? If your lady right now is bringing stuff to the table, you stick with the woman who's bringing stuff to the table. And when I mean stuff to the table, some tangibles. If she's just bringing ass to the table, that's nothing. Coochie is nothing. Coochie is entertainment. It's not an asset at all. It's entertainment. It's not a tangible. It's not an asset. It's not a viable commodity. Coochie is entertainment. It's the same as going to the movies. It's the same as going to Magic Mountain. You go there, you get entertained, you come back home with thrills. Basically, that's it. You come home with thrills. You had your thrills for the day. But at the end of the day, you're broke. If you're not dealing with a woman who's bringing more to the table than some cooch. You feel me? So always make your woman step her game up. Now, if you want to get out there in the streets, you want to run around out there and get you some females who are bringing stuff to the table, you want to get some other females who are bringing stuff to the table, that's cool. Do that. But just don't go out there playing for ass. Discipline yourself more. Man up with it. And you're going to be all right, man. Like I said, Dev, you're a little bit too young to be in a committed relationship anyway. You're only 22, man. So basically, this sounds like a guy who just needs to get that off his chest, get that player stage off his chest. Bust them multiple nuts. That's what you really want to do. Get it out your system, player. All you're going to be doing is sitting up in the house, letting it build up. Just get it out your system. Because that's what it basically sounds like. We can try to make it more complex than it should be, but it basically sounds like a brother who's in the player stage and he wants to get out. He wants to get out there in the streets, that is. But anyway, this has been another episode of Mack Lessons Radio. I'm your host, Tariq King Flex Nasheed. Don't forget to check out the website, kingflex.org, macklessons.com, and myspace.com/Tariq_Nasheed. And I will talk to you tomorrow. Y'all have a nice night. Holla.